Hey everybody, it's Norm from Tested here at Comic-Con 2018. Viewers of Tested will recognize John Eblen, master model maker of studio scale models, and now part of the Anovos family.
We are now part of the Anovos family, that's correct. We are Corbin Effects.
Corbin Effects. Yes. Now, you're still making great studio scale models of ships from Star Trek.
We are still in that universe.
In that universe. But now modernized because you guys have a Star Trek Discovery license.
We do. We've been spending the better part of the year, last couple months, whatever, working with Discovery. So what we did is we started with our Discovery miniature.
You have three ships here.
We do.
Let's start with the namesake, the title, Discovery.
Discovery.
Now, the ship here, you've in the past talked about, you know, turning digital models into physical objects.
Yes.
So is that the same process here? Because this is an intricate model.
It is. Now, you know, we get the assets from the studio. We start with that, with the digital files. Now, one of the great things about what we're doing is all of our hulls are 3D printed now. So what you're getting is you're getting a 3D printed hull directly from the digital file.
Mm.
So what you're getting is you're getting a first generation copy. You're not getting a copy of a copy of a copy. So every replica that we build, it's a one of.
Mm.
They're built one at a time. They're done off the 3D printer. So you're getting that one of one version.
And it saves you having to do tooling for certain parts when the massive saucer that comes off can come out of a printer with some cleanup.
Right. Exactly. So we're able to print larger parts. We've got the ability right there to do it in-house.
And you've engineered into it, of course, lighting, electronics in here. And I noticed that it comes apart a little bit.
We're doing what we call cutaway features, breakaway features. That gives the opportunity to see some of the unseen parts from the ship. So right here we've got the exposed engineering section on the nacelle. So there's a subtle lighting effect going on there. We can just kind of see just a little bit of the hum of the warp effects. We've also got cutaway sections showing insides of the corridors, the mess hall, crew quarters, and of course the fully detailed shuttle bay.
Mm. Now, how much of this is creatively engineered by you and your team versus what CBS has designed already?
As far as the cutaways on Discovery, those were engineered and designed by us with approval through CBS, and basically we take the history of Starship engineering,
sure,
and we try to incorporate that into what it is that we do so that it all makes sense. We don't want to make stuff up that really shouldn't be there, that doesn't exist. So we try to keep it all in universe and as closely tied to Starfleet engineering as possible.
Of course, I recognize the whole quarter layouts from technical manuals of the past, and you're kind of establishing canon a little bit because it's approved.
Hoping, we're trying, and one of the neat things about, you know, when we do the mess hall, you know, we watch episodes. Well, how many windows can you see from the mess hall?
Oh.
Let's make sure that there's that many windows in the mess hall when we're showing that. You know, how many tables are in that room? So we'll duplicate that as well.
I love the design of Discovery. The silhouette in the opening credits as it's flying, it's just so long. And at the scale, you can really see that sleek neck.
It's
strong that section is.
It is. It's very beefy in that area. You know, she's got that very low side profile.
Mm-hmm.
But as long as she is, she's so much nacelle. She's so much, you know, of that gives it that linear design.
Now, speaking of modern interpretations of old designs, you also have the Enterprise.
We've got the
something
Enterprise.
Seen in the final episode of the first season.
The last couple seconds, you know, you do catch a glimpse of the Enterprise, and I learned recently this week that there's some folks that actually haven't seen the final episode. So they were a little surprised.
Yeah.
So she shows up. You've got the iconic music that kind of cues up, and you see that ship.
No.
And it's that gorgeous meetup between Enterprise and Discovery. And I think that's something that a lot of fans, we were just kind of waiting to see that happen.
Totally.
Yeah.
Now, you've built quite a few Enterprises in your day.
We do know our way around the Enterprise.
Yeah, so highlight for me some of the differences you see in this design and how it adapts the original Matt Jeffrey's design.
There's a lot of subtle homages built all over the ship that we found. There's the classic Matt Jeffrey's design with the basic layout, engineering section, the nacelles, the dish, obviously. Now, on this ship, the nacelles are a little bit further apart.
Oh, okay.
Gives it a little bit of a lower profile, but it also gives it a little bit more of an aggressive styling, I think. Mm-hmm. There's influences from the NX-01 on there. There's also influences that we've picked up on from Shenzhou and Discovery. But again, those all, you know, they all come from the same Starfleet engineering design. So they've kind of always shared some of those same unique design aspects. And it's great when we kind of come across one of them. You know, there's definitely a lot of influence from the NX-01, you know, throughout the nacelles. You know, she's almost a little bit of a blend of, there's a little bit of Enterprise E on there as well.
Oh, interesting.
In the sense of she's got, you know, that longer deck where the shuttle bays are.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Some of the graphics and some of the striping on top of the engineering section on the strong back. It's very similar to what you see on the Enterprise E, and it's when you see that design influence on there, you know that the people that have designed this, they know what they're doing. They know where the designs have been, and they know where they should be. It's great to just discover those subtleties all over the ship.
Yeah, and the saucer reads to me like just such a tribute to the original with that angle right there.
It's got that definite, you
know, that bevel.
Yeah, it's got that on there. It's got, you know, the unique thing on this saucer is the windows. The windows are more like what you find on Shenzhou and Discovery, where they're more vertical. They're not they're not so much the round portholes
that you
see on the classic USS Enterprise.
And then you also, of course, have the Shenzhou.
Yes. She's beautiful. One of the great things about Shenzhou is the color scheme that they've chosen.
Yeah.
You know, obviously the ships, you know, all the hulls are much more metallic.
Mm-hmm.
But throwing that red on there, it gives it that race car look, which is great to as an artist to kind of get into some other color palettes besides just your whites, your blues, your subtle grays. So when you can throw some red on there, It's great. It's a lot of fun.
Now, speaking of getting files from the studio, not only do you have files for ships, you also are doing hand props.
We are doing hand props.
Let's take a look at some of these.
We've got a couple of weapons.
This is a Discovery Phaser.
So we got the Discovery Phaser. Now, basically, when we did this one, we tried to keep it as close to what the studio did with their hand props to basically recreate that as opposed to being more creative with it. So she's got a lot of neat little functions on there. Of course, you power up. Right now, she's set on stun. Move that switch. She goes over to kill. We've got a power battery indicator light that shows how much juice is left in the charge.
Very cool.
Cool thing is that the P1 comes off.
Yes.
She got the pop up screen. That was a lot of fun to kind of work on the engineering on that. So she's held in there magnetically, and of course the barrel rotates.
I love the camera influence on the design.
It's so cool to
get lens influence on the front.
It does. And you know, she's got basically just a prop trigger. The batteries are replaceable. So that's pretty cool.
And then
we've got over here.
We've got the
rifle. Yeah, she's nice. Now we were able to get a little bit more creative with the rifle as opposed to the phaser. Basically our hands weren't tied. They said, What can you do? We tried to put as many bells and whistles in as we could.
Oh.
So this one here, this is our first prototype that we did for the rifle. Extend the stock there. You can see we've got the kill count indicator up there.
Okay.
Okay. We can switch it again from stun to kill.
Yeah.
With the push of a button, we've got a turn that on. We've got our tactical light. With this one, actually, we've got the active trigger, where you can see the different modes, different settings there. She's got a tactical light on her as well. Also, she got a fold down stock.
Whoa!
So she's this one we were able to. She's pretty loaded on this one.
That is awesome.
Yeah. Again, we easily can change the batteries out in her. So yeah, give her. She's got some nice weight to her as well.
Yeah. Well, it sounds like, and it looks like you guys had so much fun designing this
and putting
all the bells and whistles
on this
design.
It's great. We started with this. We can put all this in it, and we just did the best we could.
And I know you say you're able to be creative with this. I know that just means that when they made these for the shows, they didn't need to put that much detail because they're not going to be seen up close on the screen.
Right.
But when someone's taking something like this home, they will be scrutinizing it, and that's where you're
adding.
You
want to be able to give the collectors as much value for what they're getting as possible. And if we can fit it in the rifle, we're going to do our best to make sure that we can.
Awesome, yeah. John. It's such a great pleasure to see you working on now Discovery prop replicas, the studio scale miniatures. These are so beautiful. We're going to gush over these a little more, but it's great to see you here at what part of the Novus family
at Corbin FX. Thank you.
Great to see you, John.
Thanks for watching this video. If you were watching it and thinking, boy, I wish Tested sold a t-shirt, your prayers are answered. I am wearing the first Tested t-shirt that proudly proclaims that one day builds always take longer than a day. Buy yours right now in the link below.